after the siphonostyle. So at the center point, medulla, medullated protostyle is known as that siphonostyle. Okay, after that solanostyle, scattered leaf gaps with a siphonostyle is known as that solanostyle. What is the meaning of leaf gap? Okay, when the vascular bundles are moved from stem to leaf, then this vascular bundles are okay, so it may, they are divided into, it means branches in the leaf, so they are known as that leaf gaps. When the leaf gaps are scattered, so solanostyle is formed. By the overlapping of leaf gaps in siphonostyle, so that is known as the dictyostyle. By the dictyostyle, then vascular bundles are dissected to producing small parts, so each part is known as that meristyle. Each meristyle is having that endodermis, after that pericycle, so xylem, and is surrounded by that phloem. Okay, so that is known as that stellar evolution in Pteridophyta. After that, in Pteridophyta, so leaves are small, so Pteridophyta leaves are small, they are known as microphylls, and some leaves are large. They are known as macrophylls. Right? So generally, development of the sporangia. So, which leaf contain sporangia? They are known as that sporophylls. Okay. So, it means this development of sporangia is two types. Development of sporangia is two types. First one is the leptosporangiate. Second one is the eusporangiate. In leptosporangiate, development of sporangia from a single cell. So, development of sporangia from single cell. So, that is known as the leptosporangiate condition. So, in that leptosporangiate condition, it means, so generally single cell is formed. So, in the eusporangiate, sporangia development occur group of cells that is known as that eusporangiate condition. Okay, so after that, for example, if generally some pteridophytes are homosporous condition. So, for example, in the lycopodium, and also for example in that equidium, they are the homosporous. Similar type of spores are formed. Generally, some pteridophyta are homosporous, but some plants are heterosporous. They are producing two types of spores. Some are heterosporous condition. So, this heterosporous condition means they are producing two types of spores, microspores and macrospores or megaspores. Megaspores. that is known as heterosporous condition. This heterosporous condition example, Selaginella, and second one is that Salvinia. Okay, so in that homosporous example, Lycopodium and also Pteris and Dryopteris. Right, so they are that homosporous condition. For example, this microsporophylls or megasporophylls, how it is that formation of okay, strobilus. For example, microspores. Microspores are produced from microsporangia or microspore mother cell. Microspore mother cell. Okay, undergoes meiotic division. Undergoes meiotic. Then microspore mother cells are present in that microsporangia. The sequence is important. Okay, then these microsporangias are present in a leaf. They are known as microsporophylls. Okay, these microsporophylls are arranged spirally to form strobilus.